Now, it's my privilege to bring to you our last candidate for governor of Georgia, our lieutenant governor, Casey Cagle. Casey?
Thank you very much, Barry. Thank each of you for being here. I will tell you, being in a room this size filled with conservatives gives me an enormous amount of energy and excitement as we're moving forward in this campaign. I hope all of you are just as excited as I am to witness the cultural change that is being brought about in Washington, D.C. by Donald Trump. You agree with that? Give him a round of applause. It is each of you that worked so hard and so tirelessly on the behalf of the Republican Party. It is the conservative principles that we fight for each and every day. And each of you are out there knocking on the doors and doing the phone calls and all the things that make a difference. I know that you have not lost heart. You have continued to fight the battle in the 6th District. I was with Karen Handel over Memorial Day, and I can tell you that she is working very hard. And even though California is bringing in a lot of money into Georgia and making the liberal media very, very happy, we will not allow them to steal this election from Georgia, right? We will make sure that we do our part, and I can assure you I'm excited to be a partner with her. You know, during the political season, oftentimes you hear many individuals that give you the various political talk. But I think it is important that we judge individuals based on actions. And I will tell you, as your lieutenant governor, I never run away from being a conservative. I'm proud that I am a conservative. I'm proud that I have continued to have an A-plus rating every year that I have been in office as a state senator and also as a lieutenant governor, because I believe in the Second Amendment. I believe fundamentally that it is our right to bear arms and that government has no place in trying to take that away from us. As governor, I can assure you that I will continue that commitment. That is why the NRA asked me to come to their national convention in Atlanta to be a speaker to a very large delegation of audience in which they had. But also the sanctity of life. I will tell you firsthand, I'm not a newcomer to this issue. My wife and I actually started a crisis pregnancy center, was part of starting a crisis pregnancy center in Hall County back in the early 90s. I believe that conception or life begins at conception. I believe that it is, yes. And I believe that it is our duty to always stand up for life and the sanctity thereof. And when Planned Parenthood came along and said that they wanted to do some of the things that we witnessed on film, I said, no, that's not going to happen. And the Georgia Life Alliance gave me the highest award in which they have. I am thankful for that. And when it comes to sanctuary cities, we're not late to the game on that either. Because actually in 2009, we outlawed sanctuary cities in Georgia, and I led on that issue. And we came back in 2016, and we did something else. We said, for every city and every county, you will now have to prove to the state that you are not a sanctuary city in order to receive state funding. That's the right thing to do, because harboring illegal immigrants is wrong, and we will not stand for it. But along with that, we see radical Islamic terrorism that is going on. We passed through the Senate this year an effort to ensure that we protected our citizens, and we will always be steadfast in that commitment. Ladies and gentlemen, this race is about our conservative beliefs. It is about the principles that we believe in. Certainly it's about our faith. It's about freedom in our families, and that we should never ever waver on that commitment. But it is also about where we're going to go as a state. We have fought hard to make Georgia the number one place to do business in the country. and we will continue to do that. I have made a commitment to create 500,000 new jobs across the state, both helping small business, recruiting new industry, but also growing the new types of innovation that this country and this state so desperately needs. We will not waver in our commitment to create jobs, but we will also not waver in our commitment and our desire to cut taxes. I will cut $100 million out of state spending to the tax cut to the citizens of this state in the first 100 days as your governor. And I will do it for the first four, $12,000 for the first, $12,000 of income will be exempt from taxation for a family of four. But along with that, I will continue to focus on regulatory reform. What we witness is with the I-85 collapse. No one thought that we could build that bridge back in 45 days. But that's what happens when government gets out of the way and allows the private sector to work and to do what they know they can do best. I told the commissioner, I said, don't ask for permission, ask for forgiveness. Let's get that bridge back because it is costing us $1 million a day in productivity, and we cannot have that. Along with regulatory reform, we also have to be committed to building out the infrastructure that we need as a state. I will tell you that bridge collapse showed us that our infrastructure was built for about half the size of the state that we are today. We have to be willing to go under, we have to be willing to go over, and we have to be willing to go around. And I will be a governor that will make that happen for you. Along with that, I want to end on this point. As most of you know, I have been championing and created the College and Career Academy network across the state. I created the charter system initiative across the state. Today we have 30% of our students that are under this new model of delivery of education. I believe in creating a workforce that is second to none. I do not believe in a one-size-fits-all educational system that says every single kid needs to go off and get a liberal arts degree. I believe we need an educational system that fundamentally has an academic floor, but within that floor, there are no cracks for students to drop between, but there's also no ceiling to hold any student back from succeeding. We need more eminent scholars. We need more Rhodes Scholars, but we also need more electricians and more plumbers. We've got to get back to a place in society to where we celebrate all forms of work, because as my grandfather said, all work that's honest work is good work. And that's what Republicans believe in. We don't believe in handouts. What we believe in is not an environment that traps you, that captures you like the liberals believe in. We believe in a springboard of creating opportunity and more economic prosperity so everyone can participate in the American dream. Today, 25% of our students are living in poverty. We can sit by idle, or we can say, we're going to change that. And the way you change it is through education. You give them the knowledge and the skills that they need to be competitive in a worldwide marketplace. You've changed their lives. That's our commitment. And ladies and gentlemen, that's why I want to be your next governor. Because I'm a person who lived that life. I was raised by a single mom who had to work two jobs. I know what it's like to live in a trailer park. I know the challenges these kids face, and they need someone who's going to stand in the gap and fight for them each and every day, and do it with the conservative principles that each of us believe in. I have had the privilege of serving with two governors, Governor Sonny Perdue along with Governor Nathan Deal. I have seen the governorship up close and personal. I know the tough decisions that are required, and I know what it's like to negotiate through very complex issues. I know what it's like to sit down with a CEO and ask them to move their company to this state. In business and all the businesses that I was ever involved with, I had one simple rule. That was to go out and find someone who had done it before and could do it again. Ladies and gentlemen, I know how to lead. I know Georgia, and I know how to be true to our conservative principles, and I would be honored to be your next governor. Thank you, God bless you, and God bless the great state of Georgia.
Thank you, Lieutenant Governor.